Hi guys, today we're gonna see how to set up Raspberry Pi. First take the memory card in which we need to load the Raspbian OS and mount it in the card reader and insert it in the card reader slot in the laptop. First format your memory card. For that we need to use SD card formatter. We can use operating system provided formatting utilities, but that may result in less optimal performance.
To download SD formatter, go to sdcard.org and click downloads, and I'm going to download Windows version and scroll down and click accept. Then your download will start.
Now the SD formatter is downloaded. Show in folders and unzip this SD formatter. Yeah, we unzipped and we got the setup file. Run the setup file as an administrator. Next, install. Yeah, yes. And in the meantime, check the drive which we are going to format. Make sure we are formatting the correct drive. Because like if you have formatted some other drives, it will be resulting in the data loss. So we found that H is the correct drive to be formatted. Yeah, finish. Open SD formatter. The formatter is there. Click this. Give yes. Yeah. Make sure we are selecting H drive and boot volume label. Make it as Raspberry Pi and select options. Yeah, quick off. It is correct. You format. Yeah. Yeah. Now learn. Okay, check the drive. It is formatted. Now it shows 14 GB. That's good. Now we have formatted the SD card. Now we need to download Raspbian from Raspberry Pi official website. For that we need to go to raspberrypi.org. yeah, and then click downloads. Then click Raspbian, click download zip, then click installation guide. You can able to see, scroll down a bit, Windows, click Windows. We need to download Win32 disk imager. The link will be here. Click this. Yeah. And download this. Yeah, downloaded. Now both the Raspbian OS and Windows 32 disk imager both are downloaded. Now unzip the Raspbian OS. I click extract here. You'll get a warning. Please ignore this. And then in the meantime, we will install the Windows 32 disk imager. Right click. Run as administrator. Yes. Next. Yeah. Next. 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 Install. Yeah. Click OK. Then this is extracting. Wait till the extraction is getting completed.
Now we unzipped the Raspbian OS and the ISO file is here. Check whether we are in the correct drive. In my system it is H. Now click Browse and select the ISO file and click on Write. Once complete, take the SD card out. We are done with the SD card load. Now the SD card is loaded with Raspbian OS. Now the write is successful. Check the SD card. Yes. Now the SD card is loaded with Raspbian OS. Click eject and take the SD card out. Now we are ready to mount it in the Raspberry.
First, take the SD card from the card reader. This is the SD card which we have preloaded with Raspbian OS and place it in the Raspberry. Yeah. Yes, check. And make sure we are plugging in the memory card before inserting the power supply. Yeah, now we gave the power supply. The light is glowing. And then now insert the Ethernet cable. Like here is the, and we need to insert the Ethernet cable like this. Yeah. Yeah, now done. First we have done. We have inserted the memory card. Then we have gave the power supply. And then we plugged in the Ethernet cable. Now insert the Ethernet cable in the laptop.
To connect our Raspberry Pi from laptop, we need PuTTY. To download PuTTY, we need to go to the website putty.org. Click here and select putty.exe. Yes. Now your download will start. Yeah, the download is completed now. And also we need a Xmink server. The Xmink server is a Xwindow system server for Windows. We need to click here. And then click download. Click. Yeah, where Xmink server is also downloaded. This is the very important step. Open network and sharing. Yeah. Now click this first one and click properties and click sharing and click allow other network users and also click this. Click OK. And click close. This is very important step. Without that, we can't connect Raspberry with our laptop. Now we have downloaded the Xmink server and PuTTY. Now we will install Xmink and PuTTY. Click this. Next. 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 Install. Yeah. Now our Xmink server is started. We can see in the taskbar. Yes. Now our Xmink server is started. Now open PuTTY. Run. Type Raspberry Pi dot MS Home dot net and SSH port number should be 22, and click X11, enable X11 forwarding, localhost, semicolon 0. Now click session and then give a name for this session, Raspberry, any name as you wish, and click save. We store this session as Raspberry and give open. The default username is Pi and the password is Raspberry. Now enter. Yeah, enter command lx terminal. Yes, successful. Yeah, now close this. Now give the command start lxde. Yeah, now we have opened the Raspberry. Yeah, you can see all the buttons, all the things here. Yeah, that's it. Thanks a lot for watching this video. If you like this video, please like and subscribe this channel, and also please leave your valuable comments. Thank you.